السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brother and sister, Alhamdulillah, may the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy be upon us all. Ameen. As Muslim, we always have the intention to improve ourselves every single day. We hope that today is better than yesterday, and our tomorrow will be better than today, inshallah. The importance of having this kind of intention that we want to change, we want to improve, is very important. Now, brothers and sisters, we are going to remind all of us, including myself, about the importance of people who have knowledge. Or you can say people who are seeking knowledge. Now, none of us was born a scholar. Everyone, they are born ignorant, without knowing anything at all, except those who Allah will it to be different. Like Isa ibn Maryam, Allah gave him a special kind of miracle that he spoke when he was in the cradle. The normal procedure is for people who want to have knowledge, they must seek the knowledge. You must learn. Knowledge is not something that you can inherit, but it is something that everybody must look for it. For the seeker of knowledge, the first important adab is our intention. Are we seeking knowledge for the sake of knowledge? Or are we seeking knowledge for the sake of Allah Rabbul Alameen? Now, if we seek knowledge for the sake of knowledge, you will see sometimes knowledge will make us arrogant. Knowledge will make us become very judgmental to other people if our intention is not correct. So the first adab in seeking knowledge, according to the teaching of Islam, our intention is to seek knowledge for the sake of Allah. Ikhlas lillahi ta'ala. Number one. Now, what is the sign that we are sincere in seeking our knowledge for the sake of Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create everything with signs. That means Allah did not create anything without a purpose, just for a play, but He gave a sign. The sign or the alamat of the people who seek knowledge purely for the sake of Allah. Number one, he or she have the intention to act upon the knowledge. Not just knowledge, for you to talk to people, for you to teach other people, but you yourself are not implementing the knowledge. Now, knowledge without implementation is something that Allah hates most. قَبُرَ مَعْطًا إِنَّ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah said, the group of people who like to say about this and that, only you can say about this and that when you have knowledge. But they themselves are not practicing what they say. There is a proverb, a knowledge without action is like a tree that bear no fruits. It won't bring any benefit to all of us. Now, brothers and sisters, if our intention to seek knowledge is for the sake of Allah, then you will see the difference. Whatever you learn, inshallah, there will be a blessing. Allah will make it easy for us to understand what we are learning. Because the process of learning, seeking knowledge, if your intention is for Allah, then whatever you learn, you must try to understand. And the way you understand the knowledge that you are learning, you should understand the knowledge that you are learning based on the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. Because when you talk about knowledge again, a lot of people say everything is knowledge. Yes, but what we are referring today is pure knowledge, a knowledge that will not be corrupted by anybody, a knowledge that is sure to have a good positive development in our heart, our mind, and our body. A knowledge that will make us a better person, a knowledge that will bring us closer to Allah, Rabbul Alameen. What kind of knowledge is that? Now all the knowledge belong to Allah. Allah say, "Allama al-insana ma lam ya'lam." It is Allah who has taught people or human knowledge that they know not. All of us have no knowledge at all. We are jahil. Then Allah gives us the knowledge. To whom Allah gives the knowledge? Of course, number one, to whom that He pleases, and to whom we seek the knowledge for the sake of Allah. Look at the difference between the early generation and today. In the early generation, most of the great scholars, they don't even have a formal education. They don't even have a BA or MA or PhD, nothing at all. MashaAllah. But they are great scholars. Scholars today who call themselves a scholar, a doctor, a PhD degree holder. Now, where do they get all their? He says their knowledge is from all the great scholars before us who don't have any formal qualification. Why? That their knowledge is being blessed because their intention to seek knowledge is to please Allah. And that knowledge have made them better person. A person that people appreciate, a person that have bring benefit to the generation, to the people. Now, this is very, very important. But today, you see, there's a lot of scholars who claim that they are people of knowledge. But look at our character. Look at our attitude. The little knowledge that Allah has given us, I consider whatever knowledge that we have is so small in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see how humble Umar ibn Khattab, the great caliph, the one which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him Rome and Persia. But see how humble he is. Even he is so strong with his iman, to the extent that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, any street that Umar walked, the Satan will flee away, will run. See how strong his iman. But you see how humble he is. Not like today, people who have some extra knowledge, they try to boast around. They start to be judgmental. Brothers and sisters, for people of knowledge, I would like to remind myself and all of you, remember one ayah of Allah. وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ Allah said, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ This is a good reminder. Allah is telling us, above every people of knowledge, every one of us who claim to be scholar, there will be somebody who are more learned than us. Don't always feel that, oh, after I have a one PhD, two PhD, three PhD, that means I am the most learned one. No. A layman sometimes can be more learned than us. Even he has no official formal qualification, but he has the knowledge that Allah has given him because he is very sincere and he learns from everybody. Now, a wise person is a person who learns from everybody, because everyone will be given by Allah certain knowledge that we don't have. It's not easy for you to understand what I'm trying to say here, but if you look in our daily life, don't think that the plumber are ignorant people. Don't think that the trishaw rider or the washman or the dishwasher, they are people of no knowledge. No. Even to wash a plate, you must have knowledge. It's not easy. Even to wash a plate, to clean some utensil, you must have knowledge. The knowledge of how to clean, the knowledge of how to iron clothes, everything, there is knowledge. Even the knowledge of sweeping the floor, everything, you need to have some knowledge and some experience. And again, one of the characteristics, the attitude, the sign of a good scholar, a person who seeks knowledge purely for the sake of Allah, is that that knowledge will never make him arrogant. Remember, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did remind us in one of the beautiful saying of the Prophet, لا تدخلوا الجنة মান কানা ফি কলবিহি জাররাতান মিনা কিবর, নো ওয়ান ক্যান এন্টার প্যারাডাইস দ্যাট বিলং টু আল্লাহ ওয়েন ইন দেয়ার হার্ট দেয়ার ইজ অ্যান অ্যাটম অফ কিবর. দ্য কম্প্যানিয়ন্স ওয়াজ সারপ্রাইজড, সো দে আস্ক দ্য প্রফেট, দে জাস্ট ওয়ান্ট টু রিকনফার্ম অ্যান্ড গেট দ্য রাইট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং অ্যাবাউট হোয়াট ডু ইউ মিন বাই কিবর. ইজ অ্যান আরবিক ওয়ার্ড. And the Arab is asking the Prophet again because they do not want to misinterpret the meaning of this hadith based on their own understanding. They want to understand based on what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want them to understand. So brothers and sisters, inshallah, we will come back after the short break. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, welcome back. Now we talk about the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the word kibir. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked by the companion. The companion asked the Prophet, now if a person like to dress a very expensive, beautiful dress, or a person who like to wear or own a very beautiful and expensive shoes, is that considered as kibir? Mean showing off? Because the general meaning of kibir means showing off, boasting around, telling people, no, I'm a scholar, I have all the certificates hanging here and there. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a very beautiful answer. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. The Prophet said, Inna Allaha jamil yuhibbul jamal. I repeat again, the Prophet said, Inna Allaha jamil yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful and He loves anyone who wants to beautify themselves for the sake of Allah. There's nothing wrong to wear beautiful clothes, garments, even if it's expensive if you have the means, as long as you don't forget to pay zakat. You don't forget to help the poor and the needy, and you still have something extra, a ni'mah from Allah. Why not? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam do not like any of the Muslim who Allah have given them so much ni'mah and they become so stingy. No, use the ni'mah of Allah wisely. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continue by reminding the ummah, kibir means batar al-haq. The real meaning of kibir is two. Is a person who reject the truth. You can be a scholar, you can be a professor, you can be anybody, an alim, a sheikh, but if you reject the truth is from Allah. Al-haq min rabbik. When Allah, when somebody convey a message from Allah, a saying that qala Allah wa qala Rasulullah, and you reject because of certain understanding, or maybe because it is against what you have been teaching, then that's where kibir comes in. The second one, ghamtan nas, people who like to look down upon other people. Now, a good scholar is a scholar who, when there is any problem or dispute, disagreement between people of knowledge, the scholar will behave as a scholar. He will not downgrade himself and start to be judgmental, condemning, attacking, accusing. No. This is not the characteristic of a scholar. As people of knowledge, if there's any problem, disagreement, any dispute in any matter, if we consider ourselves people of knowledge, scholars, sheikh, Imam, example, then we should settle the problem with knowledge. As a scholar, not as a normal person. Normal person, they can say anything. But a scholar, they are very careful in what they say. They are very careful, especially about Islam. They are not supposed, a good scholar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ إِبَادِهِ Al-ulama. Now Allah is telling us, who are the scholars? Allah is saying, indeed those among the servants of Allah who really fear Allah are those who have the right knowledge. Meaning, if there's any disagreement, dispute, or there's any issues among people of knowledge, people of knowledge will not criticize each other, condemning each other, backbiting each other. No, they don't do that. What they will do, they will try to call up each other and sit down and discuss the matter with knowledge. We are not going to solve our problem based on our emotion, our feeling, because we are people of knowledge. But what is happening today is very sad. People claim that they have knowledge. When some scholar makes some statement, maybe being human, we may make some wrong statement based on question raised to us, and we are not aware about this issue, and we may give some fatwa. We may do some mistake, yes. Like Imam Malik, rahimallahu alayh, he also remind his student that I'm a human. I may be right, I may be wrong. But if I'm wrong, I'm going to pull back what I said. And you don't have to follow me, it's just my mistake. Now, this is very important, brother and sister. Nobody can say that he will never make any mistake. But if you are a good scholar, if you know the other scholars, example, the other scholar is also your friend. He may make some wrong statement. What is our duty, brother and sister? To grab the opportunity to condemn him, to criticize him, to humiliate him? That is not the attitude of a scholar. If we do that, what is going to happen to the general public? If we show them this kind of character, negative character, what do you think is going to happen to them? Now, our student will be also very judgmental. They start to condemn scholar. Who are a normal student to condemn scholar? How can we allow this thing to happen? And this is happening today. Very sad to say that, brother and sister, because we who call ourselves scholars are not careful of what we are going to say. I'm not saying that you cannot make any comment. I'm not saying that you cannot give advice or correct what is not correct. Yes, we can do that. But you must use the knowledge that Allah has given us. Maybe what is lacking among scholars today, they may have knowledge, mashallah, the knowledge of tafsir, the knowledge of hadith, the knowledge of usul fiqh, the knowledge of all the linguistic terms, but we have very little wisdom, hikmah. Now, knowledge without hikmah is not helping us. It's not good enough. And this one thing that Allah has given to our Prophet, al-hikmah. Now, what is hikmah? In the Quran, Allah always reminds us about hikmah. Hikmah is to follow the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So I would like to remind all my good brothers and sisters, especially those who feel that they are people of knowledge, those who have studied from Azhar, from Syria, from Saudi, from Jordan, from any Muslim country that qualify you to become a Muslim scholar, please, if there's any issue among the people of knowledge, prove to yourself that you are a man of knowledge. You solve the matter with knowledge, not by condemning each other. Sometimes a lot of people, student of knowledge today, na'uzubillah, some people who are very sincere, some have a very bad agenda, bad tension. They come to the majlis ilmu not to increase knowledge, no. They just want to create fiction, division among scholars. They know that this scholar is a friend to this scholar. Now this guy, maybe one of the statements of the first scholar displeased him, make him very sad. Now he's going to another scholar and he was bringing some saying from this scholar, the first scholar, and ask the second scholar just
to get another fatwa to attack the first scholar, so that the second scholar will condemn the statement given by the first scholar. And this is happening everywhere. It's very sad. What should we do? Being a scholar, again, if we really are sincere and have adab, then we will remind the questioner, if this question or this statement came from another scholar, you should be humble and go back to the scholar and ask him to give you a further explanation. Maybe what the scholar said is correct, but our understanding as a student of knowledge is not correct. There must be a difference between people of knowledge solving problems than people who have no knowledge. Even Allah have asked us, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ? Allah asked us this question. Say, is it the same between people of knowledge, people who know, and people who knows not? It cannot be the same. People who have no knowledge, they just say anything, they do anything they like with the hawa, based on their feeling. But people of knowledge will not do that. They're very careful because they have knowledge. The knowledge will guide us. So brother and sister, please remember to honor the knowledge that Allah has given us. Be humble to the knowledge. And the best thing, each time when we seek knowledge, each time when you read any book of knowledge, ask Allah to protect you. Allahumma zidni ilman nafi'a wa a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa. Ask Allah to give you knowledge that benefit you, and ask Allah to protect you from knowledge that do not benefit all of you. Amin ya rabbil alamin wa billahi tawfiqi wal aqli da'wana أن الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته